the vision with a distributed file server is that there is no central server anymore. Each file is distributed across several servers. What does it mean? To avoid the unscalability of a central server, we want to take a file and distribute it across several different nodes in the local area network. Since the DFS is implemented across all the disks in the network, if a client wants to read or write a file, then it actually is contacting all the servers potentially to get the data that it is looking for. And which means that since each file is distributed across all of these different servers, the I/O bandwidth that's available cumulatively across all of these servers can be used to serve the needs of every individual client. Also, this allows distributing the management of the metadata that is associated with the files among the server nodes that are available. Furthermore, we have more memories available in all of these servers cumulatively, which means that we have a bigger memory footprint available for implementing a file cache, including all of the server memories, plus the memories that may be there in the clients as well. And that's where we can actually go towards cooperative caching among the clients as well. So in the extreme, we can treat all the nodes in the cluster, whether we call them S1 or C1, we can look at all of the nodes and say they're all the same with interchangeable roles as clients or servers. That is, we can actually make this DFS a serverless file system if we allow the responsibility of managing the files, serving the files, caching the files, equally distributed among all the nodes of the cluster so that the roles are interchangeable between clients and servers.